Happy second last week of January, everybody. Welcome to the latest installment of News Channel 3's exclusive video environmental blog called Your Environment. We also have other blogs out there. We'll be doing more about astronomy, and also you can check out our weather overtime video blog when, again, we post that at various points in time. And thank you again for joining us. We're going to be talking this week a little bit more about what you can do to help out the environment. Again, a little bit more about volunteerism, a little bit more about getting your hands dirty with citizen science. If you've never tried that before, maybe something to get your kids interested in, getting out into the wild to the state parks of Tennessee or wherever you may be happening to go to. There are some cool things you can do both with nature when it comes to your exploration and also using things like technology, something, again, you can use to keep track of data, and other government agencies can use your data keeping, your record keeping, your wandering and exploring to actually help the environment. We'll talk more about that as well. Plus, light pollution may not seem like pollution per se, but it's one of those things that we really do need to think about, especially if you're a stargazer, an astronomer. It gets very difficult to see a lot because of the fact that we use so much energy to produce so much light that goes to waste. And there's a lot better ways to do things like that to be able to kind of reduce the amount of energy we use and the amount of light that is wasted that just goes up into the sky that makes it almost impossible to see the stars and the planets at nighttime. And that's something that we are losing rapidly with more urban areas growing very quickly. So we'll talk about that as well. Plus, we'll take a look at how much time is left until Earth Hour and a little bit more about what's going on again into and around the area where it comes to how you can help save rainforest space with just the click of one button. So stay tuned for more on that. All this information, again, if you know about that, you're already on the page, WREG.com/weather/environment, and it will be, again, adding this to our main menu at WREG.com on the weather side coming up in the course of the next week or two. So stay tuned for more on that. Have to thank the Chickasaw Area Group of the Sierra Club for inviting myself, Dr. Dorian from University of Memphis Earth Sciences, to talk about not only climate change, but also climate and science communication where it comes to the media. A great opportunity to do so. And if you'd like to find out more about where these guys are located, you can go to sierraclub.org/Tennessee/Chickasaw. And you can find out more about their monthly meetings, their activities, their abilities to get the word out in regards to pollution and recycling and land conservation and all the stuff that they do. Good opportunity to learn more. Again, their website, if you'd like that, all you have to do is email me as well. Good news, the Tennessee Conservationist newspaper is going to be, it's a bi-monthly magazine published by the Tennessee Department of Conservation and Environment from the state of Tennessee government. It's going to be going to 100% post-consumer recycled paper. Doesn't sound like a lot, but every little bit that we can reuse paper out there instead of producing new stuff is going to help reduce waste, reduce energy usage, and the strain on the environment. It may not seem like much, but if you recycle an aluminum can, it takes 95% more cost and energy to mine more aluminum ore, process it, purify it, pulp it, get it ready to go for processing into can shape than it does to just reuse that aluminum all over. So reduce, reuse, recycle. It does, excuse me, come in very handy and does actually make a difference, believe it or not. Now, the Naturalist and Tennessee Department of Environment and Conservation are starting a new idea out here that's going to be doing a really cool thing to help to make certain that the environment is protected at least a little bit more, and you can help out on this. When you go out to state parks, they're introducing for 2019 their BioBlitz program to where you, when you go wandering out in the wilds, can take a look at numbers of trees, different species of insects, problems that might arise when it comes to anything in the way of conservation, trash that needs to be picked up, overuse of different park facilities out there. Very neat place to take a look at that. And if you'd like to know more, it's all available through the Tennessee Department of Environment and Conservation, or again, you can go to inaturalist.org for more information about how you can participate in BioBlitz 2019. It's a citizen science project. You don't get paid for anything, but your data could help a lot of people do more research in the course of the next several years. Citizen science is very important, and if you'd like to know more about this, all you have to do is go to tn.gov, search environment. Again, you can go to tn.gov/environment for more information about what goes on out there, including what goes on with the lives of the park rangers, conservation programs, how you can get information about using state parks. This is just for Tennessee. Other states have websites that have tons of information available. So again, a good opportunity to learn a little bit more about that. They're also online, where you can also get more information about the entire program, including that BioBlitz program that was listed on the Tennessee Department of Environment and Conservation Twitter feed as well. And again, you can get that at twitter.com/TN Environment for more information, or you can go to their Facebook page. Tons of information there about getting out and about and learning more about what goes on in Tennessee state parks. But if you're at another state or any place else out there, take a look for your state's environment and conservation efforts through state government, and also on the local level as well. Great opportunity to see more about that. The Memphis Museums organizing and running the Lichterman Nature Center has a good opportunity to learn more about seeds. They're going to have a seed swap coming up here in the course of the next week, January 26th, 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. at the Lichterman Nature Center on Quince, and Breakfast with the Birds. Good opportunity for kids to learn a little bit more about science of the environment as well, and a whole bunch of other events coming up for not only January, but right on in through March, a STEM camp coming up at Camp Lichterman that's available at memphismuseums.org. Wolf River Conservancy doing a lot to help make certain that the Wolf River Valley is preserved and cleaned for future environmentalists, and also, again, for your opportunity to get out and see a clean environment out there. But there's a ton of stuff coming on, including the 14th annual tree planting, which will be happening Saturday, February 16th, and the first Saturday members paddle. If you're a member of the Wolf River Conservancy, you can help paddle the Wolf River. But coming up in the near future, the tree planting in February, good opportunity to get your hands dirty and learn a little bit more about what's going on out there when it comes to conservation and especially erosion into and around the area. So something to consider there. And again, for Monday, for Martin Luther King Jr. Day, the day of service, picking up trash in the Wolf River Valley, good opportunity to see that. And they also have a lot of citizen science listed out there at wolfriver.org for more details on that. CleanMemphis.org has more coming up tomorrow for the days of service. And if you'd like to know more about what the opportunities are and what areas they cover, you can find out more by going to their website. Looks like the map is having some difficulties, but they cover all the areas in green and are looking again for volunteers to help out. And that can be found at cleanmemphis.org. And you can find out more about becoming a volunteer there as well. And also on their Facebook page, facebook.com/cleanmemphis, with Clean in Memphis capitalized on there. So something to think about. Light pollution, something to consider if you're an astronomer, and something to consider, again, to find out where the best dark sky sites are around the area. Memphis and the Shelby County metro area, lots of problems with light pollution, but a lot of areas throughout the Mid-South, Arkansas, Tennessee, and Mississippi have some pretty good spots that you can go to that would be areas to see the planets and the stars and to get away from all that light pollution. We're losing a lot of our dark sky sites because of all the light pollution that is out there, so something to consider. Here's what you do. Go to therainforestsite.com, click on this big green button, and by viewing the ads on the page, you help to save, maybe a little bit too many ads there. You help to save rainforest space. By clicking and viewing those ads, the sponsors will pay for rainforest site to be bought and put aside so it's not developed into farm territory. The rainforests are the lungs of our planet, so something to consider when it comes to making certain that we preserve that. And so far, just for this year, 960,000 clicks have saved 480 acres. Now, that doesn't sound like much, but we need every drop of rainforest space that we can possibly get to make certain our planet's air is healthy. Coming up, Earth Day in April, but before that, we've got, again, Earth Hour, 68 days until we turn off the power, learning more to do more with less, making certain that we use less energy by turning off the lights in our home and business. And you can participate in that, again, by going to our website and finding out more about how you can lower your costs. Anything going on out there in the way of environmental, recycling, ecology stuff, let me know. I'd love to know more about that. And you can find out more details at austen.onek@wreg.com. Email me and let me know. And stay tuned for more. Again, coming up next week, we'll have another update of our online environmental blog, Your Environment. Thanks for joining me for this week, and stay tuned for a lot more coming up at WREG.com/weather.